Hello students, today I am going to teach you coordinate geometry, which is very important for your CET exam. So here I am going to have the first question. Find the inclination and y intercept of the line root 3x plus y is equal to 3. So how to simplify this? We'll make it very simple now. We're going to find the inclination here, that is the angle, and y intercept. So now you can see slope m is equal to minus a by b, which is minus root 3. You can see, compare this equation with ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. And take the AB. A is root 3 and B is 1. Therefore, M is equal to minus root 3. And we also know that M is equal to tan theta, where M is nothing but minus root 3. We have to find the theta, that is the inclination. So here we are going to write here minus root 3 is equal to tan theta, or theta is equal to tan inverse minus root 3. So minus root 3 you can directly calculate, and you can write this here. Minus is taken outside. So tan inverse, only root 3 you are going to write. Remember the inverse formula, and it is minus 60 degree. So this is what we have, the inclination. Next, we have y-intercept. So we are going to find the y-intercept here. So y-intercept is given by minus c by b. So where you can see, compare the equation again. C is on LHS side, bring it on RHS side, it is going to become minus 3. Therefore, minus of minus 3 divided by 1. 1 is nothing but b. So minus into minus is going to become plus. And here we have 3. So therefore angle inclination is theta minus 60 degree. And y is nothing but the intercept, that is plus 3. So like this, student, we'll go with the next example. Find the slope of the line perpendicular to 5x plus 6y plus 8 is equal to 0. We have 4 options A, B, C, D. Let me see the solution here now. To simplify this, you should remember the equation slope of the line perpendicular. We'll just simplify this now. So now you can see, what is the slope m is equal to? Compare the equation again, it is minus a by b. Remember this formula, very very important. So minus a by b, a is nothing but 5 and b is nothing but 6. Therefore, m is equal to minus 5 by 6. So you should be fast in CET. Therefore, what is the slope of line perpendicular? Remember, this slope, whatever you have written, minus 5 by 6 is not the slope. It is just a slope. We want to find perpendicular slope, so which is given by just reverse the slope here, it is going to become minus 1 upon m, or we can write this as minus plus 6 by 5. Similarly, students, we'll go with the third example, that is find the equation of the line whose y-intercept is 5 units and makes 45 degrees with x-axis. Now here also we have again 4 options A, B, C and D. By looking at the question, you can just see that what is given given is y intercept 5 units is given and it makes 45 degree, that is the angle 45 degree is given with x axis. Therefore I write this as c is equal to 5, theta is equal to 45 degrees. Immediately student, you should remember that we are going to use the formula, that is m is equal to tan theta. Already theta you know, what is theta? 45. Substitute tan 45. Tan 45 is nothing but 1. So like this, therefore you are going to take the now equation of the line. So how you are going to write the equation of the line? You should remember the formula for equation of the line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. Immediately you should write the values m is equal to 1 and c is equal to 5. Simplify the equation, we get this as y is equal to 5x plus 5, therefore x minus y plus 5 is equal to 0. So therefore here the option is c. C is the correct option. So like this students, now see here students, very important. Next question, we are going to go with the find the slope of the line joining the points. So they have given 2 points. Here also we have 4 options. So very simple, you should know the formula and you should use the proper trick to simplify this. Now immediately you can see, we take the solution. How to simplify this? I will tell you, very simple. So you should first know what is the equation of the slope. First you identify x1, y1, so that is 2 and 5, I write, and x2, y2, it is 4 and 6, identify this, important. Next you go with the slope, remember the formula of slope, slope of the line joining. So this is m is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So substitute the values immediately students and get the answer. It is 6 minus 5 divided by 4 minus 2, which is equal to 1 upon 2. So this is, we have the option as B. B is the correct answer. Now similarly, we can go with the next question, that is find the slope and y intercept x intercept of the line 2x plus 3y minus 11 is equal to 0, and we have 4 options. Now students, you should immediately simplify this, very easy, but how the question is given is very important question. To find the slope as well as the x intercept and y intercept, so a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, and identify this c is equal to minus 11. Already in the previous example we have done. So first we find the x-intercept. See, this is a very tricky question. So x-intercept is equal to minus c upon a, which is equal to, so you have to identify here c is nothing but minus 11, substitute it here, a is equal to 2, substitute immediately, so minus into minus is going to become plus 11 upon 2. Similarly we'll go with the y-intercept. Immediately students, you should remember the and write the formula y-intercept, practice this formula again and again. So y-intercept is equal to, remember this formula student, that is minus c upon b. So minus c, minus right as it is, minus c is nothing but 11, minus 11, and b is nothing but 3, therefore minus into minus plus, so it is 11 upon 3. So therefore the correct answer here, we have 11 upon 2, 11 upon 11, that is the option a. A is the correct option. So remember this, like this one should simplify very fast in the CET. So immediately we have the next question. I have taken very important and repeated question. Find the equation of the straight line which passes through the point minus 1, 2 and parallel to the line 2x plus 3y plus 1 is equal to 0, and we have the 4 options. So options are very similar. You have to identify the correct option here. Only by solving we can do this. Next you can see, immediately we'll go with the writing the formula. First you identify what are the values given and then simplify the problem very easily. You should be fast in the examination students. So just I will write here first. slope of m. M is equal to minus a by b. Already you know this, students. A is nothing but 2 and b is nothing but 3. Substitute the value, so we get m is equal to minus 2 by 3. Next, since the line parallel, therefore what is the slope? M is equal to minus 2 by 3 itself is the slope. So whenever it is parallel, m is equal to minus 2 by 3, that is itself is the slope. Now we find the equation now, students. So see here, again remember the equation of the straight line. So practice this formula, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. You should be fast in the examination, student, therefore I am going fast here. This implies y minus y1 is 2. Write it here, 2. M is minus 2 upon 3, substitute, and then x1 is minus 1. Now if you say simplify, it should be simplification must be correct here. Multiply here 3, 3y minus 6 is equal to, multiply here minus 2 inside the bracket, minus 2x, minus into minus plus, again minus 2. And then if you just simplify this, you are going to get this as 2x plus 3y minus 4 is equal to 0. So this is the answer we get. So therefore in the options, if you identify the option number 6, C is the correct option. So like this, you have to identify the correct option. Next question will go in immediately, that is find the equation of the line passing through the point 6 minus 4 and perpendicular to the line. So again we have here line and point is given, and here we have four options. Again they have given A, B, C and D. Now immediately, student, you should first identify what is the slope given. So therefore m is equal to slope of the line minus a upon b, which is equal to minus 7 upon minus 6. So it is 7 upon 6. So this is the slope of the line, but here we have this slope is perpendicular to the line, therefore what is the slope when it is perpendicular? So since line is perpendicular, so I can write like this, it is reverse, therefore minus 1 upon m, therefore it is minus 6 upon 7, which is written as minus 1 upon minus a by b. Remember this formula, student, very very simple. Therefore now we find the equation of straight line. So practice this, students, very very important. Equation of the straight line formula, you should remember y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Substitute all the values, students. So you can see m is already given, so already we have simplified. So y minus, substitute y1, it is minus 4, which is equal to minus 6 upon 7 x minus 6. Substitute the value, simplify, multiply here, 7 minus minus will become plus, so 7y plus 28 is equal to minus 6x minus into minus plus 36. If we say further simplify, it is 6x plus 7y minus 8 is equal to 0. So like this, students, you should identify the question now and write the answer properly, then you should choose the correct option. So it is 6x plus 7y minus 8 is equal to 0 is the correct one. It is A. A is the correct option. So in the CET you should be fast now. This is the next example, that is the lines are given, 3y is equal to 5x plus 8 and 6y is equal to 10x minus 7 r. So four options they have given. Now we are going to simplify this. Yes, we can do this very simple and very easily. By taking the two lines, we just find first what is the slope. First you have to arrange this question. I am going to take this as question 1, equation 1 and equation 2. In the equation, I will just simplify this. From equation 1, it is 5x minus 3y plus 8 is equal to 0. Arrange this equation first. Then you have to simplify this find the slope. Already you know the formula, slope m1 is equal to minus a by b, which is equal to minus 5 by minus 3, which is 5 upon 3. Similarly, student, go for equation 2. From equation 2, arrange the equation first, very very important. 10x minus 6y minus 7 is equal to 0. Lot of students make mistake in the equation. Then find slope m2 is equal to minus a by b. Now again substitute the values, minus 10 upon minus 6, which is again 5 upon 3. It means that m1 is equal to m2, which is implies this in the coordinate geometry, it is lines are parallel. So when the lines are parallel, m1 is equal to m2. Therefore, the option here we have parallel lines. Immediately, student, we go with the next example, that is find the equation of the median through the point B. Remember, through the point B, given that the vertices of the triangles A, B and C. Very very important question and very repeated question, and it is little bit tough questions in the coordinate geometry, and it is a tricky one. Yes, so first you have to draw the triangle here. I'll mark this as A, B and C. So from the B we have median. It is nothing but the midpoint. We also considered give the name as D also. So I first have to find the midpoint. I know A and I know B, so I'm going to take the midpoint of AC, which is equal to, I'm going to write the formula, x2 plus x1 divided by 2 and y2 plus y1 divided by 2. So substitute the value, students, here. So identify what is x1, x2, y1, y2. It is minus 3 plus 4 upon 2, minus 6, minus 1 upon 2. So further, if you simplify this, I'm going to get the value as 1 upon 2, and here we get the minus 7 upon 2. So remember, this is our midpoint D. I'm going to call this as the point D. So now, students, we are going to find the median. So I'm going to write the equation of the median here. First I will take the point B, that is 3 and 7, and point D, that is 1 upon 2 minus 7 upon 2. So this, instead of midpoint, I'm going to take here D. So I'm going to find the equation of the median. So equation of the median of median B D or DB is, so remember, write the formula, y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, x minus x1. Remember this formula, very very important formula to find the median. So substitute all the values, y minus into minus plus, so it is 7 upon 2 is equal to y2 is 7, y1 is 7 upon 2 divided by again x2 is 3 minus 1 upon 2. Substitute the values, x minus x1 is nothing but 1 upon 2. From point B and D we get this, and then simplify now, multiply 2, 2y plus 7 divided by 2. Here we multiply 2, here we get 14 plus 7 divided by 2. Take the LCM, students, already you know the LCM, 6 minus 1 upon 2, and here we get the value x, 2x minus 1 upon 2. When you simplify, cancel 2, 2 in the numerator and the denominator. In LHS side and RHS side, cancel 2, 2. Yes, you should be fast in the CET, students. So therefore, simplify, we get the value as, if you further simplify, we get the value as 5 2y plus 7 is equal to 21, 2x minus 1. If you simplify, we get the value, multiply, open the brackets and simplify further, we get here 21x minus 1 5y minus 28 is equal to 0. So students, if you look at the option option number we get this as C, that is 21x minus 5y minus 28 is equal to 0. So students, like this, all the examples, formulas, you remember, practice and substitute the values every time. Here in this example, we have taken median through the point B. Suppose in the exam, they may also ask median through the point A as well as median through the point C. Just simplify, substitute, change the points and get the answer. All the best for your examination. Thank you.